Hi, my name is Pat Trimby and I'm the EBSD product manager at Oxford Instruments Nanoanalysis. And in this short video, I'm going to explain to you a little bit about how orientation maps work with respect to EBSD data. So I'm looking at our AZtecCrystal software, which is our new software for processing EBSD data, and I'm looking at a data set from a quartz rock sample. Now the raw data that we collect is shown in this table here. A series of x and y coordinates, some phase information, and three angles known as the Euler angles, which correspond to the three-dimensional orientation of the crystal lattice at each point. Now in this form, the table doesn't help us very much. So what we do is we take that data and we plot it in the form of maps. So I'm going to switch to the map view. And in its simplest form, all we do is we take the three Euler angles and apply a red, a green, and a blue color to the three angles. And this gives us the color scheme that we can see here in this map. Now clearly we can identify different grains and we can identify ribbons in this material that have similar orientations, as shown by the similar colors. But the Euler angles are very difficult to interpret. So normally what we do is use an inverse pole figure coloring scheme. So this is an inverse pole figure X scheme, which means it's coloring each point according to which crystal direction is parallel to the X direction of the map. And we can do the same for the Y direction and for the Z direction. So if we go back to the Y direction, here you can see that large areas in the map are colored a red color. And that we can interpret as the C axis of the quartz crystals is predominantly lining up with the y-axis of the map. And I can show that by zooming into the legend in a little bit more detail. And here we can see that the red colors correspond to the 0001 direction being parallel to the y direction in the map. So AZtecCrystal also allows us to look at the individual orientations in a graphical form. And we can do that by switching to the individual point selection mode. If I click on one of these red grains, we can see the orientation of the unit cell shown on the left-hand side as it is relative to the map. And we can see that the C-axis, shown by the blue arrow, is roughly parallel to the map Y direction. And this would be the same for all of the red colored grains that we can select in the map. Looking at the dominant red color allows us to interpret the crystallographic preferred orientation of this particular sample. And so when we look at the pole figure, it's no surprise to see a dominant cluster of C-axis orientations close to the Y direction, as shown in the left-hand pole figure. And there's one final thing that we can show in AZtecCrystal. If I go to a higher zoom, and then I'm going to switch on a grain display in which we will put the unit cell orientations of every grain superimposed onto the map itself. And this graphically allows us to view the texture or the orientations as represented by the colors. And once again, we can see that dominant preferred orientation of the C-axis. So I hope this helps you in your interpretation of orientation maps as generated from EBSD analyses. Please look out for some more videos relating to our EBSD products. Thank you.